Set the current day and time. The first step to setting up the programmable thermostat is to accurately set the current day and time. First, press the Set Current Day/Time button found right here. The day of the week is displayed here, just below the time. To modify the setting, press the Day button repeatedly until the display indicates the current day of the week. Next, set the current time. Pressing the Up and Down buttons under Change Time/Temp makes precise adjustments. Press and hold the button to move more rapidly through the minutes. While in this mode, pressing the Set Current Day Time button increments the time ahead by 1 hour at a time. To confirm the changes you have made while in Set Current Day Time mode and return to normal operating mode, press the Run Program button. Set Program. After the thermostat knows the current day and time, we need to tell it when the building will be occupied and when it will be unoccupied. It is possible to have two different time periods each day of the week when the building will be occupied. This is useful if you have seminary in the building in the morning and then youth activities in the evening. To tell the thermostat when the building will be occupied, set the occupied start time and unoccupied start time. If the time readout is blank like this as you press Occupied Start Time and Unoccupied Start Time, then there is no time on that day of the week when people will regularly be in the building. Just as when we were setting the current time, we use the Day button to move through the days of the week to set the occupied and unoccupied times for each day of the week. As one would expect for a church building, on Sunday, the system is currently set to be occupied, the ending or unoccupied start time being 5 p.m., and the occupied start time is set for 7 a.m. Proceeding through each day of the week, we see that there is a program set up for Wednesday. That's when our youth activities are held in this building. It is currently set for an occupied start time of 6:30 p.m. and an unoccupied start time of 8:45 p.m. To delete a program, clear each start and end time by pressing the Clear Start Time button here. This only clears the time for the entry for unoccupied start time on Wednesday. You can see that there is still a time set in occupied start time. Let's go ahead and restore the program the way it was. To do that, press the Change Time Temp up and down arrows. In this mode, the time entry changes in 15-minute increments, and holding the button down will again move rapidly through the times. Again, to confirm the changes we made and return to normal operating mode, press the Run Program button. Set the temperature ranges. After we have set the current day of the week and time of day, and programmed the thermostat to know when the building will be occupied and when it will be unoccupied, we need to set the desired temperature ranges. Let's start by pressing the Heat Cool Settings button, and we enter the mode to set the temperatures for the cooling system. Pressing it again will change the mode to where we will set the temperatures for the heating system. Pressing the Occupied Temp button will allow us to set the desired temperature for when the building is occupied. Notice that the display changes to Occupied. Since we're currently setting the temperature for Occupied Cool mode, the system will turn on and blow cool air if the temperature rises above 70 degrees. To change the setting, press the Change Time Temp up and down arrows until it displays the temperature you want. Let's look at the heating settings now by pressing the Heat Cool Settings button again. Now we're in the mode to set the temperature for occupied heat mode, and the system will turn on and blow warm air if the temperature dips below 68 degrees. To change the setting, again, press the up and down arrow buttons until you have it set to the temperature you want. As you notice, when we cycle between the heat and cool settings by pressing the button repeatedly, we can see that this thermostat is set to keep the building between 68 and 70 degrees when occupied. We also need to set the temperature ranges for when the building will be unoccupied. Pressing the unoccupied temp button and then the heat cool settings button to cycle through, we can see that the current settings for this thermostat will allow the building to get as cool as 65 degrees and as warm as 79 degrees when the building is unoccupied. Those temperatures are just fine and we don't need to make any more modifications, so we will again confirm our settings and return to normal operating mode by pressing the Run Program button. System and fan modes. A couple of items that we haven't touched on yet are the system and fan modes. The system setting determines the basic mode of the system between several options, including auto, its current setting, which will turn on either the heating or cooling, depending on what the thermostat and programs determine, heat, which will only turn on the heating system when the building gets too cold, but will never turn on the cooling system, off, which is rather obvious, and lastly, cool, which will only turn on the cooling system when the temperature rises too high, but will never turn on the heating system. Obviously, auto is the preferred choice for optimal comfort. The fan button will change between auto and on. Having the fan set on will run the fan continually to circulate air through the building, whether the heating or cooling systems are on. Auto will only run the fan and circulate air when either the heating or cooling systems are running. This is a more energy-efficient setting and should provide excellent comfort year-round. Thanks for watching this tutorial.